Last night, I watched Abducted in Plain Sight on Netflix. Now, this actually isn't a Netflix original documentary. It was originally on Amazon, but Netflix bought rights to it. And now, of course, that's when the word gets out and everyone's watching this thing, and deservingly so. So it's the story of the Broberg family, and specifically their daughter, Jan, who was kidnapped by their neighbor, Robert Burchold, AKA B. So here are my thoughts about the whole thing. B is a mastermind. This plan he had to how to manipulate the parents to get to his true love in Jan was so methodically thought out. I mean, this guy definitely had a read on the dad, Bob, being a closeted gay man. And remember, they're in the Mormon faith. So this is a big no-no and would bring huge shame to him and his reputation if that ever came out. And what B connected to this was, if this man's a closeted gay man in this marriage, his wife's clearly not fulfilled sexually, maybe as she'd like, and he took advantage of that and seduced the mom, Marianne, probably the most polarizing and controversial figure in this whole documentary. And he used both of their crutches here sort of as blackmail, but the messed up part about it is the truth of this story, I feel, is they wanted these affairs to keep going. I don't think that the handjob in the car was the only incident with Bob and B. I think that was a relationship that was going on. And clearly, Marianne loved the affair she was having with B. I mean, during the documentary, look how she just reflects on it. You can see it in her eyes, and it's really messed up and weird because this guy raped her daughter. That's what made this documentary mind-blowing to me, is how they got a lot of confessions out of these people. A lot of stuff was revealed. I didn't feel like it was holding anything back. And it was shocking. And I don't think the parents realized how bad this made them look. There's also the part of them, how much were they complicit with all this? Which we're gonna dig into more. And the only thing I do wish more about the documentary was they got more into the Mormon part of their community. I think it's such an important thing. It was a little overlooked, but why it's so important is because that's the catalyst to which would cause the shame in their part if people found out about her affair, or if people found out about the husband being homosexual and having an affair. So when they signed off to drop the charges on the first kidnapping that happened with Jan, they selfishly chose their reputation in the community over the justice and safety for their daughter, Jan. And that is undeniable. So anyone who's making the case that the parents are getting too harsh backlash, I don't see that angle. I know B, like I said, was a master manipulator, but even in that manipulation, you should be more aware when something like that's going on and consequences of it, because you're still making adult choices where Jan didn't have those choices. And sometimes this documentary is going so fast, it's throwing a lot at you and it's riveting. Edge of your seat the whole time, but you really have to take a step back and think about what they're telling you. Think about this man, B, married their 12-year-old daughter in Mexico and kidnapped her to do it, but they weren't weirded out by him being in a room alone with her and knew that was going on. And he says it was for therapeutic reasons. Even if the kidnapping never happened, the marriage never happened, I still wouldn't let that happen to my kids, period. I don't care what therapy you're saying you need to go through. It's not happening on my kids' risk, sorry. It's really sad and odd and makes me dislike the parents for that. And what's really sad about this whole situation is, you see in real life, Jan recently tweeted, again because of the backlash towards the parents, she said they were manipulated too, it's not their fault, but I do also think that's on Jan's part. She's gotta process, if she was to believe it was their fault, it's a lot of hate to take in, and I get it. And it's a lot, it's overwhelming. But from an outside objective point of view, that is my view as well, that these parents are responsible in ways too. And remember, you could see in the interviews, the parents were trying to paint themselves at certain points as victims. But the only victim in this story was Jan. And she was victim to the three people she trusted the most in her life, her parents and B. So that's heartbreaking to think about. And that's why this documentary is so effective, because it did, I believe, have that intention for you to get that. And because that is the biggest opinion that people agree on. And man, obviously everyone's freaking out about the mom blushing, thinking about B, but then she goes and does this book deal. All that money better go to her daughter or some kind of charity, because that does not make it look good either. So this whole documentary was stomach turning. It was highly effective. Once the alien stuff started happening, I actually turned the lights on in my room because the real stuff creeps me out more than any horror movie. I was worried that we saw the daughter was alive right away, but that's what actually made this different from a lot of true crime documentaries and made it so riveting, hearing her side of everything. So it was good they did that. They got a ton out of everyone they interviewed, and that includes B's brother as well. So that there makes it a must watch. I can't tell you how many times you've watched true crime documentaries and they're asking questions, but not the ones everyone really wants them to ask and not getting those answers. This, you feel like you're getting those answers. I never felt shortchanged. And man, there was some really powerful stuff. I think the hardest part to watch when she was first getting raped by B, and they had in the recreation shot her looking up and saying that she had to look at the trees to get through it. This is something you see in a lot of shows when they show scenes of rape and how girls will react sometimes, as that is the only thing keeping them going. It's super sad, and it really showed you though what really happens here. So it's a fearless documentary. Jan was so open with everything, and that was a beautiful thing, and props to her. And back to this alien stuff on the recorder, freaked me out. It really showed you how vulnerable a child's mind is. You can teach them anything. Telling her that these aliens had a mission for her to have sex and have this child, or there's gonna be big punishment. It's the same mindset of being overly religious parenting. It's the same exact thing. It's just showing you, no, Jan wasn't crazy when she was 16 or 17 thinking that still was gonna happen. That's how she was brainwashed. That's how she was raised. That's her upbringing, and it's awful. And it was surreal, the part she's talking about where, oh my God, if I don't accomplish his mission, now he's threatening to take my sister, so I'm gonna shoot my sister and then kill myself. That almost was a real thing that happened just from the power of brainwashing a child. I really think here you also have a part two in this where you can delve into the psychology of the parents and get into that Mormon part of it. Where did their upbringing come from that they were okay with so many things that were happening and why they did what they did? And it was super interesting because people talking about what makes someone a pedophile, what makes them think that way. There was some stuff in there about B. And that psychiatrist telling him he was this way because he was abused as a young boy by his aunt, and he had to take care of his little sister at an early age, and he kind of attached to that and clinged to it, and that he wanted to take care of someone like a little sister, which was Jan. It's just an interesting thought and trying to explain where that thinking comes from. Who really knows, but I was happy they addressed that. My love goes out to Jan for telling such a haunting, honest retelling of her tragedy and so open about it. I think this will help so many people, and I don't think her parents realize how bad this will make them look. A classic overdone reaction with true crime and shows like this is to blame the parents, but in this case, I don't think it's arguable on the other side of that. I think, yeah, they're a big part of this happening. That girl was getting molested under their nose, had chance after chance to end B in that whole family's life. I mean, even when the FBI warned them to not talk to that whole family anymore, they did not listen. And you almost think, wait, was this the parents both equally thinking about their sexual temptations with the man? They couldn't let go of him. So it gives you a lot to think about, talking with all my friends and coworkers. It is worth the hype. I'm giving this a 9.8, never bored, edge of my seat, no BS here, no fluff, actual confessions, good reenactments, and it was fearless. And that mostly has to do with Jan. So props to her for sharing this story with everybody and making you just wonder about the world and humanity. So take it or leave it, but it's effective. Let me know what you thought of it down below, your opinions on it. I'd love to hear it, especially for this one. I read every comment and try to respond as many as I can. Please follow me at SteveVarley1 on Twitter and Instagram for more of me. And please subscribe so you don't miss one of my reviews to TV shows, movies, and I'll see you next time.